Rebecca, you recently won your another Best Actress award. Did you expect it?
It was actually quite unexpected. You know, the months leading up to Star Awards, there will be reports, you know, who's the hot favourite and who will be the dark horses, but my name wasn't even mentioned in either of these categories. So when my name was announced, I was actually really, really surprised and I didn't know how to react. I think there was no reaction on my part. It was just emotion upstage. To some people, they may say that it doesn't matter to them whether they win or not. But to me, I feel the award speaks a lot and it has a lot of weight, especially if it's once a year, you know, and it's the biggest award ceremony in Singapore. So I mean, I wanted to win it, but if I don't, it's okay. There's always next time, or, you know, I just got to work harder.
You actually have a degree in accountancy and law. So was being an actress something that you had been dreaming of from the time you were young?
Not at all. I actually never dreamt that I would be doing something like that, or I never aspired to be an actress or model or just anyone in front of the camera, because growing up I was very sporty. I didn't really care about my appearance. I was pretty plump. Even in school plays, I wasn't interested in being casted as a lead or even a supporting cast. I was just very happy doing props or moving the furniture, just being in the background. So this career choice was actually very surprising, not only for myself, but for the people whom I've grown up with, my close friends, my family.
Do you see this as a lifelong career, you know, doing it when you're in your 50s and 60s?
Well, I definitely hope to still be in this industry, to do something that is related, at least. To be an actress, I guess I don't foresee myself, or I don't give myself that much pressure to continue being an actress till I'm 50 or turn 60. Also because it's actually physically very demanding and emotionally very demanding as well. For me now, priority is acting, but hopefully in the near future or in the future, I really hope to open like a school, like a bilingual school for kids, so that they can start learning or having interest in Mandarin at a very young age. And I think that's very important because that was something that was lacking in my education, or it was just stubbornness on my part to hopefully to do something related to that and to build confidence of young kids, because I feel those are the initial years that are very important to building up a person's self-esteem and a person's belief in him or herself, which to me was a little bit affected because I was made fun a lot of in school. So hopefully to build this his place or an outlet for kids to grow and to grow in an exciting and nurturing environment.
Thanks very much for having lunch.
Thank you.